This is my sister, Rosie. She means the world to me.
What I love about Michael, he does have a heart of gold. He has a great sense of humor.
I could describe myself. I have Betty Davis eyes and Freddy Krueger feet. They're so tight in the front, they're killing my toes.
Have you got one on before, or?
Not in a couple of years. My toenails are really painful because they keep hitting each other because they are super long. My feet look like creatures. Looks like creature's foot. Oh, my left foot is killing me.
Oh my.
It all started about 18 years ago. And then it just spiraled downhill. I was a wrangler. I used to feed the horses, let them out, ride them, train them, break them. I love working with horses. When I was working on a farm and working in the stalls, I'm almost positive that's when it started. My feet started getting sore, and before you know it, they were turning colors. There was nothing I could do. So it just progressed and progressed and progressed, and I finally had to quit.
So you're saying they're hurting really bad, and like, honestly, I've only seen your feet like once or twice before.
You wanna see what they look like now?
Yeah, let me have a look, let me see.
You sure?
Yeah, I have to say. Oh, God.
Isn't that terrible?
Oh, my God. That's really bad. They smell, too.
Oh, you can smell them now?
A little bit now that you took your sock off, yes. Yeah. Oh, Lord.
They smell like rotted tomatoes.
It's so not healthy.
I was battling for a long time. I would cut them here and there. By the time I cut them, they were growing back in again. All different ways. They were going upside down and twisting sideways, and just nothing helped. What a mess, huh? Here, I'll click them for a couple times.
You can see like the dust coming off them.
It's like my mating call.
That's really gross.
If I click them hard enough on a floor, I could river dance.
Oh my.
You wanna see me dance?
I don't know. I guess. Ugh.
You wanna see him? It's about as best as I could do. Look at the scratches on the floor.
That's gross. They must like really hurt.
You can see where it's digging in. It's bleeding. My plan is to go see Dr. Schaefer and hope that he can fix my feet.
That's infected. That's infection. You need to see him like ASAP.
Okay.
Because this is gonna make you very sick.
It already is. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired of my feet smelling like this and looking like this. Something's gotta be done.
So toenail fungus is, you know, a very interesting and unique thing to treat. It's really gross looking, it can be painful for a patient. The nails can be very thick and discolored. Sometimes there's a smell to them. Toenail fungus really just comes from a moist environment that creates a lot of fungus in the shoe. So you really have to watch, you know, that water doesn't get in there, that moisture doesn't build up to prevent foot fungus. My next patient is Michael Fenari. So I first met Michael on a video call.
Hi, Dr. Brad.
He has some pretty gnarly feet. I really hope that I can help him.
Hi. I'm here to see Dr. Schaefer. I'm very nervous because nobody's seen my feet in 18 years, except for my sister Rosie. No friends, no family, no nothing. I don't want to scare anybody.
Michael?
Hi. Part of the reason I didn't go see a doctor was because I was so embarrassed. I was ashamed of people seeing my feet. I hope Dr. Schaefer could fix my feet.
Yo, Michael.
Hi, Dr. Brown.
How are you doing, buddy?
Good.
Welcome to the new normal. Looking at you across from the computer screen, your toenails looked pretty funky. I remember you were saying like it smelled and stuff.
I used to wear two and three pairs of socks. just to hide the smell because you used to come through my boots.
That also, too, is making your feet sweat more. Mm-hmm. You know, it's cultivating more of that environment where the fungus is going to grow. But, I mean, you also don't want to stink everyone out of the room, you know?
Exactly.
I would love to take a look at it.
Ugh, you're going to have nightmares.
trust me, I've seen a lot.
Ugh.
All right, let's take a look at your right foot.
This one's a little better.
Okay.
Because they fell off about a year ago. They grew back a different way this time.
Wow.
My toenails look like spaghettis. Some of them to swirls. It's gross.
Does it hurt when I press on them?
That does. Even though they're so thick, they're so tender.
Right. Well, Michael, every step you take, they're probably lifting up.
They are.
It has to be brutal.
I haven't worn shoes in I don't know how long.
This one's curling completely under your pinky toe.
Yeah.
Do you feel yourself walking on that?
Yeah. Feels like pins and needles.
Like pins and needles? Oh, wow. When you have toenails that are growing up and, you know, out front, every step you take in a shoe, the shoe is going to lift the nail up. I mean, it's basically like you're taking a nail and pulling them off with pliers. It's like, it's torture. They're so brittle. I could hear them.
Yeah.
Wow, they really do make sounds.
Yeah.
My friend, I'll say this. I've never heard a sound come from nails like that before, so you are a first. I mean, Michael's neglected his toenails for a long time. And in some people's cases, they just say, forget it. You know, and they decide just to not treat it, and then it grows to the extent where Michael's is right now. As far as like your nails are concerned, that's like a classic fungus, which is called tinea ungum. Tinea ungum is like the medical term for toenail fungus. And that's when the nails become very thick, they raise up and they become discolored. When you have toenail fungus for years and years and years, it's almost impossible to kill that. If you don't eventually remove these nails, you could get ulcers underneath these nails, which could lead to infections and which could possibly lead to amputations. Today's the day of Michael's surgery. His toenails have a lot of fungus to them. It's so painful to where it's affecting everything that he does. They need to be removed, not just for himself, but for his health. So the surgical plan for Michael is to remove every single toenail. It's called a total nail avulsion. And then we'll also kill the nail base or the matrix so those nails don't grow back again. You know, the challenge with Michael's case, his nails really grew thick, you know, and kind of spiraled in some cases. So I'm really gonna have to be careful removing them. Maybe they could be brittle and just kind of crumble. It could be really problematic. All right, so we're about to start Michael's case. We're gonna start with his right foot. Each one of these large toenails is gonna be removed. I'm gonna free him up. All right, we're gonna start removing each toenail for Michael. Cool, so we just finished the matrixectomies. His nail matrices are all removed. That's gonna prevent his nails from growing back so he never has to deal with fungus ever again. You know, Michael can definitely river dance, but he's not gonna be listening to his toes clank when he does it.
Everybody responds to anesthesia differently. Sometimes in surgery, people wake up.
Okay, hang tight, man.
Don't move your foot yet. Don't move.
When I'm working down there, and if the foot moves, it can really interfere with what I'm doing in a really dangerous way.
Relax.
Thank you.
Relax.
This is a problemsome situation.
Don't move your foot. Michael.
I'll hold.
Michael. Relax, Mike.
Hang tight.
He's a strong dude.
Just lay still.
Thank you.
They're all good, right?
Yeah.
The surgery went great. We got every nail removed. His nails and feet finally look clean. Michael's free of his toenail fungus.